Okay, guys, and welcome back. We're just about to start episode 2.
Mr. Toad?
Do something, Bigby, before he completely tears up the place.
Oh, little recap.
Whoa, hey!
You've got something on your face.
Fuck are you talking about, you stupid cunt?
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
Please, Bigby. Promise me you won't tell Beast you saw me.
I promise.
Thank you for trusting me.
Have you seen my wife? Have you seen Beauty?
Come with me.
Shit went down.
Don't interrupt me, Miss Snow!
You asked me a question.
Don't change the subject. You are to blame for this unpleasantness, Miss Snow.
I'm Dee. He's dumb.
But he said if word of this ever got back to him, if he ever thought you knew, or Miss White, we'd come back and kill my boy.
I'm looking for the woodsman.
Well, he's not here.
Ollie, you're out of paper towels and, they're gonna string me up, Bigby. Said it looks fucking bad. It looks really bad, but I didn't do it. Ah! You said you wouldn't hurt me.
You said you wouldn't run. This fucking lab dog. He comes sniffing around this place. The rich fucks in the woods need a shakedown. Ain't that right, Bigby?
Now things are worse off than they've ever been.
Well, that's not true.
Right. We've had it worse, but not by much.
There you go, a little recap of what happens, followed by Snow's, finding Snow's head. Fun. So, let's get back into it.
Making this more difficult than it has to be. If you just cooperate and answer the questions, you can go home. Maybe get some sleep. How are you feeling? I know it's been a long night for you.
Oh.
You look like you could use some rest.
I'm feeling pretty fucking pissed off right now, if I'm honest. I'd like to smash everything in this room.
Is that a threat?
Depends on how much you like the furniture.
I didn't think that was funny, in case you were waiting for me to laugh.
I thought it was.
Look, that's me. I know what you must be going through. Really, I do. But I could use your cooperation.
You don't know anything. If you did, you wouldn't be sitting here talking to me. You'd be talking to the piece of shit that did this.
Well, you stonewalling me like this isn't helping either of us, so why don't you cut the shit and...
Ho-ho! Want someone jumping up at Bigby?
I'm trying to help you, Bigby.
What is it with you cops? Always trying to empathize with people. I know this must be hard for you. Do you? Do you fucking know? Have you had a friend killed and their head left at your fucking doorstep?
I can't say many people have.
No, didn't think so. Your nose is bleeding. Are you... okay? You don't look so good. Detective Brannigan?
I'm Detective Brannigan.
Yeah. I know. I just said that. Is there something?
going on?
Please. Please. I'm sorry. Just make it stop. Please.
Is her head gonna explode? Oh, thank God.
We have to go, now.
What did you do to her?
She'll be fine. It's just a memory wipe spell. Very expensive, but it works. The whole station will forget the last 24 hours.
Bloody
and everything
hell.
They saw at the Woodlands. Well, hurry up.
Ooh. I was wondering how Fables, how things happened. Shit. Ooh.
Thanks for bailing me out.
Certainly. We found the woodsman chained up to a post last night. That was your doing, correct?
Yeah.
Well, thanks to you, there's been at least some hope in this whole dreadful affair. I'm confident he has some information about the slayings. Bluebeard's currently interrogating him.
Oh, God.
And he's already to the point of confession. He was involved, definitely. That much we can tell from his babbling. He just must have had some sort of accomplice.
Yeah, good. I've got questions for him.
Well, we all do.
King Street.
I know what you're thinking, Bigby. It's been one full night and a slice of morning, and I already miss her too. You know, I never get more homesick than when one of us dies. And now, for it to be snow, I've never been good with these sorts of things. I just can't believe this is really happening.
Yeah. It's hard.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused. Did she, give any indication to what she was thinking? When you saw her last, I mean. I don't know why, but I'd like to know that she was, I guess, fine, I suppose.
She just told me to be careful.
She was always fond of you, Bigby.
Yeah.
Oh, poor Bigby. She was like his thing.
I don't know what else to say, Bigby. We have to put an end to this.
Ooh.
It's been two murders in as many days. We don't unearth our culprit, and soon there will likely be another on our doorstep tonight.
I'll get it done.
Please, Bigby, for Miss White.
I got it.
Oh, he's pissed. So is he now. He just ruined his car.
As I came down the bowery, a new angel
Oh, the woodsman.
Met a maid who asked my trade. Sailor John, said I. And away, you Santy, my dear Annie. Oh, you New York girls, can't you dance the polka?
Look sharp, woodsman. You have visitors.
Why is he singing?
Some sort of pathetic defensive mechanism. Never mind that, though. He will tell us eventually who killed Snow White. I have too many methods to inspire him.
Bluebeard, I told you not to touch him until we returned.
I didn't. Well, barely.
And yet you saw fit to retrieve
it. It's hardly been used. Yet. Hello, Sheriff. Come to help? Because I think I have a secure handle on things.
Yeah. Help.
Good. I didn't think you'd have any objections, of course, to this whole thing. Not with your history. But sometimes people surprise you.
The sheriff is here to carry out the rest of the interrogation.
Oh, really?
Let me tell the story. I can tell it all. About the mountain boy who ran illegal alcohol.
Woody.
That you, Bigby? I didn't kill that girl, Wolf. And I don't have a thing to tell you, so get me the fuck out of these straps.
Save your energy. You'll need it later.
Woody, if you don't tell us who murdered Snow White, this, right here, is as good as it's ever gonna get for you.
Snow White is dead.
I'll tell you what I already told this blue dandy. I didn't kill anybody. I can't tell you anything.
You can't or you won't. Look, I got questions and I know you have answers. Whether or not they're the answers I want, well, I guess we'll find out.
Whenever you're ready, Sheriff.
Back at the bar, why'd you run?
Look, I got nothing to say, so just let me go. Please, just let me go.
Do you see now what I've been dealing with? What are you going to do about this?
I'll take care of it.
What are you planning to do, exactly? Don't forget what we talked about.
What did you tell him?
We must do whatever it takes to find the killer.
Yes.
We'll see. I prefer to play things by ear. If you don't start talking, and I mean fast, you'll pray to any god who'll listen that your mother never shit you into this fucking world.
It's not worth all that. Fuck.
You want to tell me why you ran now?
I don't know what to tell you. I ran because I didn't want trouble. I didn't kill that girl. I have no damn clue what's going on.
You told me he was at the point of confession.
He was. He is.
He said Snow wasn't even supposed to be there. Now what do you exactly take that for? He knows what's happening.
All right, that's something. Did you say that, Woody? Where are you talking about? Where was she supposed to be? What was supposed to happen?
She was... nothing. Nothing was supposed to happen. It's my own shit, all right? Just forget it. Where's my stuff? I want to smoke. You took my smokes.
We, confiscated his belongings. For the time being. This was all we could find on him, in any case. Nothing exceptional to speak of.
Much like the man himself, I'd say.
It's...
What's that?
You want to know what this is?
Oh, shit.
No. Take a good fucking look. Take a good long look. Etch it into your fucking memory.
I told you, I have no goddamn clue about what's going on. I didn't have nothing to do with it.
Tell me what you meant by Snow wasn't supposed to be there.
You've got it all wrong. I can't. Just leave it alone. I don't want to talk about it. Just a waste of fucking time.
Snow wasn't supposed to be where? Where was she supposed to be?
I didn't say Snow, okay? I never said that.
Yes, you did.
She wasn't supposed to even be there. She, that's it. Not Snow.
I don't know fucking anything about snow.
Okay, that's something. You weren't talking about snow, but who did you mean? Who wasn't supposed to be there?
I can't get into it.
I'm talking to him at the minute because I don't want
this whole thing sucks.
Who wasn't supposed to be there? Who are you talking about? Woodsman, you gotta talk to me, because Crane and Bluebeard, they think you're shit. But you think I don't know what that feels like, to be the bad guy?
Yeah.
You know, you're just trying your fucking best and to still get shit on day and night.
Yeah, I know you do, Wolf. Don't you want to find out what happened to those girls? To Snow White?
Let me handle this. Woody? Who wasn't supposed to be there?
The girl.
Which girl?
I can't... Just let me go.
Stop protecting whoever murdered these women. I don't care what your friends have told you. You have to tell us what's going on.
The girl... It was... Faith, all right? Faith.
Faith? This is about her?
I was expecting someone else, and this girl I didn't even know shows up.
Who were you expecting?
I don't know.
Talk! Now!
No one's behind anything. This... I can't get into it. It's my own personal shit, so fuck off! Ow! Fucking Christ, I'm tied up here! Fuck!
Who were you expecting?
Bigby, really, this has gone far enough.
Who was it? Tell me.
Lily.
Lily? Who's Lily?
Lily is... Holly's sister.
Holly? The bartender?
From the Trip Trap?
Her sister's...
Yeah, detective. Her sister's a prostitute. I was a regular of hers, okay? I paid, she did her thing, and that was it. When Faith came to the door, it just set me off. Lily usually comped me if I didn't have cash. Fucking bitch Faith didn't have any decency. So la-di-fucking-da, congrats. You cracked the case wide open, shithead.
Sheriff, that is it, okay? I have to put a stop to this. I warned you earlier, and you haven't listened. And now it's just truly gone too far. The man has rights.
His rights are on temporary leave.
Bluebeard, that's enough now.
You don't give a shit about the woodsman's rights. You just don't want any heat on you.
You're not thinking of the bigger picture here. You never think out the ramifications for things. Beating information out of someone will simply never get the people aligned with us. I dare say this is the exact kind of infantile rashness that got Miss White killed.
Fuck you!
I only meant, you know...
What's going on down here?
What? What the hell just happened? She's not dead? Someone else is being hurt? What's going on? I don't get it. What the hell? Smoke and mirrors. Oh, smoke and mirrors.
What the hell was going on down there, Bigby? Abusing a prisoner like that. I thought you could control yourself.
I thought you were dead, Snow.
And that makes it okay?
I hope it was worth your time.
No.
You really scared us. If we'd just known you weren't actually dead...
I was working on this case. After a conversation in the taxi last night, I got a call from Toad. He said his son found a body. We thought it was Faith at the time. Getting her back here wasn't easy. But hopefully we'll find something on her to help us track down the killer. Or at least to figure out who she is.
I'm glad you took care of things.
Thanks.
Well, at least this little thing isn't gone now.
Snow?
What is it?
I'm glad you're not dead.
Me too. I just want to get to the bottom of this. I just feel like...
What is it?
I feel responsible, in a way. She looked just like me. And maybe that's why she was killed.
Snow, it's not your fault.
But she looked just like me. That can't be a coincidence. We just have to find out who did this. And why she was glamored to look like me. I mean, that's what it is, right? So, what's our next move?
Maybe you should lie low for a while? Until we figure out what's going on.
And what? Sit around the business office twiddling my thumbs, waiting for the big bad wolf to solve all my problems?
That's not what I meant.
Well, then what did you mean? I told you, I'm tired of sitting around. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once.
I'm not yours to lose.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Poor Big B.
I know it's dangerous, but I'm not helpless. I can take care of myself. I've been doing it for centuries. TJ is waiting inside. He was so freaked out last night, he wouldn't tell us much. Even now, he just stops talking altogether after a certain point. He's pretty shaken up, though, so try not to be too, you know.
Myself.
Right.
Oh, we get to see Big B in his wolf, well, almost wolf form.
TJ's over there. I don't know if you want to talk to him first or after, but let me know when you're ready to see the body. I want to be there. Buffkin, do you have a second?
Of course, Miss Snow.
Going on with the tarot cards again.
Well, that's appropriate. The moon. Usually this is about deception or confusion. But for me, well, who knows? I hope you can find what you're looking for. Acids. Maybe this has been harder on him than I thought.
What's over there? Talk to you in a minute, TJ. I'm told. It's a glamour.
Snow's perfume.
So, check out anyone who fits that profile. You might start with Bluebeard.
Right away, Miss Snow.
Are you ready to examine the body now?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness! I almost forgot.
Come on.
witching well. Chamber, right? Ooh. Maybe Faith's not dead then.
Wow. I didn't realize.
Are you gonna be okay? You don't have to stay.
I want to stay. I'll be fine. It's just a little strange. The glamour is so effective, it's invasive. But just do what you need to do. Check her mouth. There might be a ribbon in there. Like before. Anything?
Nothing.
Can you close her mouth? Thanks. That's weird. I don't wear a brooch like that.
Maybe it really belonged to her. Not part of the glamour.
Looks like something from the homelands. Bufkin, do you recognize these symbols?
No, nothing I've seen before.
It looks just like Faith's did.
But there was nothing in her mouth this time. Do you think it was done by the same person?
Hard to tell. Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
No. He said he wanted to run more tests.
What are Dr. Swinehart? Oh, claws.
Rope marks.
She was tied up?
There were cinder blocks tied to her ankles.
Cinder blocks?
So she would sink.
Oh.
Track marks.
She used Mundy drugs?
Looks that way. Pretty heavily, too. I hear they only go for the legs if they've used up the veins in their arms, or if they're trying to hide the marks.
Wait. If the glamour is supposed to make her look like me, shouldn't it be concealing things like track marks? That brooch, too. Why would it change everything else? I've never seen one this sloppy.
It's possible it's designed not to.
Designed not to hide track marks?
Good point.
The witches upstairs know what they're doing. That's why they cost so much. Unless someone is making glamours illegally?
It's not technically illegal, miss. It's not encouraged, for sure, but there aren't any laws specifically forbidding it.
So there's some sort of black market for glamours?
One would assume so. Mm. I imagine anyone with access to the proper books and training could theoretically produce a glamour.
Yet another thing to worry about. Black market or not, it's a pretty good match. Look at that. The buttons aren't exact either. There's an extra one here.
Oh, what's in her hand?
Her fist is clenched.
So she fought back?
No marks on the knuckles.
Oh.
Maybe she was grabbing something?
Maybe. What are you doing?
Only way to find out.
Jesus, Bigby. What is it? Flowers.
Yeah. You're right. These buttons are wrong. I wonder...
What?
Snow, do you mind if I, open her coat?
Bigby, just let me do it.
Okay.
We're making progress. Let's see what else we can find.
Well, I certainly hope you're behaving yourself up here, now that you're done punching people. What have you found out?
Her glamour is defective.
Defective?
We are thinking it's black market. We should really be regulating this kind of thing.
Yes.
We should keep going.
What is that?
It's your perfume.
How do you know what perfume I wear?
You can't fool this nose. Also, I saw the bottle on your desk.
Yeah.
Looks like someone picked it out for her.
So, someone gave her instructions. I've seen things like this before. It's definitely magic, though witches don't usually craft objects these days.
I don't think it's wise to fool around with that. It's some kind of black market magic. Who knows what it could do? We should have it looked at, just to make sure it isn't dangerous. Don't you think?
You may be right. One way to find out.
What?
There's something in here.
How do we open it?
I think I can figure it out. Something to do with these rings here.
Oh. Will I ever be able to work out this puzzle? Oh!
A deer. What does that mean? Oh.
Is that Snow's hair?
Is that...
It's your hair.
Someone must have taken this from my apartment. I noticed it was missing, but I didn't think... This was the last picture I had of Rose and me. My sister and I don't talk much anymore. Who did this, Bigby?
Glamour wearing off?
She's a troll?
You gotta be kidding me.
That's Thingy's sister.
Alright, you can calm down. It's not like you haven't seen a troll before.
Who is she? That wasn't there before. Who do you think she is? I don't know many trolls, I'm afraid.
Should have left them all back in the homelands.
You don't mean that, do you?
With that tattoo, it's gotta be Holly's sister, Lily. The woodsman told me about her.
You're right. She was reported missing, but I guess it just slipped through the cracks.
We have to go tell Holly.
Right. Who knows? She might know something about this. Who Lily was seeing.
Well, certainly another troll.
Do you want to talk to TJ first?
Yeah, I do.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
We'll fill you in later.
Good. Good.
Oh, Miss Snow, I have a question.
Excuse me a minute.
Let's go speak to TJ then. I feel like I'm trying to be a good guy, but I didn't mean to punch fucking woodsman. I was meaning to do it good. It just broke.
Oh, that's enough. Mira, vanish! Cancel! No.
What the hell are you doing?
Don't even get started with me, Sheriff!
What's going on?
I saw what you did down there. Is that how you treat your prisoners? The woodsman may be a good-for-nothing drunk, but that don't mean you can just whack him around because you feel like it. You scared the shit out of me, little boy. He saw everything.
Okay, Mr. Toad.
No. I want an explanation.
And what did you expect to see?
I thought maybe I'd catch you on the shitter.
But I saw something worse, didn't I?
That's enough.
God.
Mr. Toad, I deeply regret the distress this has caused you and your son. But right now, we need to carry on with the investigation. I will be happy to speak with you about your concerns later, but you must understand how urgent this is. We need to talk to TJ.
This ain't over, Big B.
TJ. It's all right. Are you ready to talk to Mr. Wolf?
Watch yourself, Big B. You do anything to hurt me, boy.
It's okay.
Are you okay?
Go ahead, TJ.
I go swimming at night sometimes, in the river. I wasn't doing anything bad, I promise.
Of course you weren't.
We know you're a good kid, TJ.
You're not in trouble. Just tell me what happened.
I was there, under the big blocks. And I heard noisy feet. And when I hear that, I'm supposed to go underwater and stay real still and quiet.
That's right, son.
Then I saw... I saw the lady!
Careful, Big B.
I wasn't.
I know.
The lady fell in.
Oh, bugger.
But,
everyone's
but
terrified of
her. She didn't have her head on. I thought she was gonna pull me down too. Cause she had rocks on her feet and she kept falling down in the dark parts.
He means the cinder blocks. You saw the rope marks. Is there more, TJ?
Is it true? You know when people are lying? I heard you could do that. That's why you're the sheriff.
Yeah, part of my job is being able to tell when people are lying. I'm really good at it. Is there something else you want to say?
Please, don't be mad.
What is it, TJ?
I didn't stay under the water.
What?
I know I'm supposed to, but I was scared, and I went to the top again. I couldn't help it!
I gave you very specific rules. You have to stay quiet and out of sight or bad things can happen. I told you!
You're not in trouble.
Like Ellie's not.
Not this time, Toad.
So you didn't stay underwater?
I don't know if anyone saw me, but someone said, stop laughing. And then I was scared, and I went under for as long as I could.
Wait, you heard someone?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell us before?
I didn't want to be in trouble.
Did you hear anyone laughing?
No.
Did you see who it was?
No.
Okay, TJ.
I'm sorry. After I came up again, there was no one there. And I ran home, that's all. I promise. I want to go home.
Okay.
Yeah, you can go.
You can go.
Thank you, TJ.
Okay, son.
You did a good job, kid. Come on, then.
Oh, bloody hell. Sorry about that noise. My controller likes disconnecting and reconnecting itself. Don't know why.
That went about as well as I expected.
Everything okay?
We should go.
You can't go out there.
Why not?
It's too dangerous. Someone tried to kill you. Bigby, you can't let her go out there with you. You'd be putting her life at risk.
Bigby is not in charge of me.
He's in charge of this investigation.
That's not the same thing.
If Snow wants to come with me, I'm not gonna stop her.
But...
we should leave now. You ready?
Yeah.
Oh, choices there. I'll bet you I picked the wrong one there. Oh, the chip back.
This whole thing is complete bullshit, and always has been. I mean, what's his job, really?
To keep shit from reaching the woodlands. Jack, I don't know where they are.
You're a bar. You're supposed to have darts around.
And I normally do, but who knows where the fuck they went to after...
Come on, Holly. I need entertainment. This'll do.
Okay, I know. Just relax. I'm not here to start anything.
Okay.
Miss White, I heard you had kind of a strange morning.
It's been kind of a strange morning for everyone, I think.
Every time I see this guy, he seems to lose weight. It's amazing. It really is. He loses weight and yet somehow keeps all the muscle.
Jack.
Wolfie, my dear, how are
Jack,
you?
Jack, eh?
Because, you know, we were just talking about you. All of us. At the bar, here.
I just need to talk to Holly. Privately.
All right, just give us a second first. I'm dying to hear about the body that came out of the East River this morning. It was a fable, right? Oh, everyone knows.
The toad was just here.
You said it looked like Snow White. That true, love?
Yes. It's true.
So we were just wondering why, of all the possible suspects in Fabletown, why would you arrest the poor old woodsman, who you know had nothing to do with these murders? Bigby, come on. You can't be so dumb as
Jack,
to...
find the off button, now!
What is it with you two? You and Gren are all, let's get a posse together when there's no one around, but as soon as the big bad wolf walks in, your tails go between your legs. Cat got your nerve? What happened?
What happened? I'm tired is what happened.
Tired of what?
Of trouble, Jack. I'm sick and tired of trouble. I don't want any more. So just stop revving his motor, or wait outside, or fuck the hell off. I don't care which.
Jack.
What? Bigby, look. Two fables are dead. And shit, Gren's sister...
Holly's sister.
Holly's sister has been missing for what? A few days now? And we haven't heard word one about it from anyone. Hey, easy! Ah, fuck! What'd I do? It's an honest question.
Go fuck on up a beanstalk, Jackie boy.
Gren, you gotta learn some new lines. Let me tell you.
All right, then. Actually, have there been any updates?
I don't know how to say this to you, Holly. The woman we found in the river.
Who was it?
You know who it was.
God fucking damn it! Of course, the dear princess, Snow fucking White, is all safe and sound. Where were you when we reported this weeks ago, huh? Where are you when we ever fucking need you? If you'd give 1 ounce of a shit about her, about any of us, she might have been saved. She might have been cared for. She might have been...
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry we found your sister this way, and I wish this had ended up better.
Hmm.
Holly.
Get the fuck out of my bar.
I just want
to... It should have been you. It should have been you, and it wasn't.
We recovered this from her personal effects. I thought you might like to have it.
I didn't know she still had this. The copper was from a dwarf mine.
That was decent of you.
Oh.
Gren.
Yeah?
Take off for a bit, would you?
Are you sure?
About her life. Honestly, we didn't talk often. She was lost here in the city. She just got swept away by it.
Why were you two not talking?
It seems so fucking petty now, but I didn't want to watch it with her. I think she was off the Monday drugs, but she was hooking to pay down debt. It ate me up to see her that way. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie. The owner, Georgie, with all his fucking fees. It's a crock of shit.
Said Georgie.
That's how they kept her under their thumb, really.
Holly, it's okay. If it's too much, we don't have to do this.
Georgie. Not the first time I've heard that name. What do you know about him?
We can just go talk to him. We've got a lead. Maybe we can take it from here.
Lily.
Thanks for everything, Holly. Is there anything we can do to...
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy, and I don't need charity.
It's not charity. It's looking out for our own.
Is she... Where is she?
She's at the business office. She's taken care of.
I'm gonna have to go down there and get her. Fuck.
Please, we can handle the funeral arrangements.
No. It's a kind of... It's a formality with trolls. We burn our dead by sunrise, or... I don't know. Some old world shit will fuck your soul up.
Of course.
Okay. Good.
Let's go down to the business office and start making the necessary preparations, all right? That club?
I'll go down there now. See what I can find out from the owner.
You were good with her. I'm impressed. Really? Thanks. It just made everything easier.
Wish I didn't beat the shit out of Glenn, but, well, you know, at least I walked away from him. I didn't rip his arm off like I could have. What kind of shitty joint is this going to be then? Pudding pie! Strip joint. Ribbon.
Oh! Sheriff, what a nice surprise. I'm not sure I've seen you here before. You're always welcome, of course. Is it business or pleasure? Or both?
I've got some questions for Georgie.
Straight to business this time, then.
Yes, unfortunately.
You're in luck. He's here. Come on. I should warn you that Georgie does not like to be bothered when he's working. And he's in kind of a mood right now. I mean, more so than usual.
Is he, alone in there?
He's working with one of the dancers, but don't worry about that. Discretion is our guarantee.
Discretion? Oh, God. I might actually have to do some censoring if this is as bad as I think it's gonna be.
Welcome to the Pudding and Pie, where we cater to the diverse tastes of the Fable community. Your pleasure is our pleasure. Your desires are our desires. Your imagination is the menu, and discretion is our guarantee.
Did you know Lily? She worked here?
My lips are sealed. You'd better ask Georgie.
That?
For fuck's sake! What do you think you're doing? You look like you're trying to take a shit. Who's gonna want that? No one's gonna want that. You fucking dozy bitch.
Nice place.
You do have a sense of humor. That's good. Good luck.
It's your face.
Oh, God.
Smile. You never smile. How many times do I have to say it? Oh, it's you. We're closed. Keep dancing, you. I didn't say stop. For fuck's sake! You, stay right there. Don't even think about sitting down. We're not finished.
You, Georgie.
Brilliant deduction, Sheriff.
Thanks, Wadu.
What do you want, then? You here for a little taste? Tell you what, come back after midnight, maybe. I can hook you up.
Oh.
Or, knowing you, this is probably not quite your style. You'd prefer someone who can take a bit of a beating. Tell me, do you prefer a stationary target or one that will put up a fight? I can arrange whatever you like for the right price.
I'm not here for that.
Oh, I'm not here for that. You just stopped in for the chips, then? Jesus, Bigby, you're so corny. I love it, though. No, seriously, I love it. Okay, all right, Sheriff. Just fucking with you. Look, I know why you're here.
Are you sure?
Listen, Sheriff. Around here, we can't afford to wait for you and your swanky pals to take an interest. We have to look out for each other. When shit happens, I hear about it. Especially if it concerns my livelihood.
In that case, I assume you knew Lily was glamoured.
Of course she was, you daft git. She was a troll.
No. I mean glamour to look like another fable.
Yeah? Well, so what? Who gives a toss? People get up to all kinds of things when nobody's watching. It's their own business.
You know, it's illegal to impersonate another fable.
It's frowned on.
It's illegal as long as I don't like it.
Oh.
The 13th floor would never provide a glamour like that. It's strictly black market stuff.
Ooh, black market, is it? How exciting. This is exactly what I would expect from a thug like you. Storm in, throw around a bunch of accusations, try to scare people. But you've got fuck all to back it up. And we're all just meant to jump any time the wolf shows his teeth. It used to be something, you know. Get that out of my face.
This was part of the glamour we found on Lily's body. Take a good look. She was impersonating Snow White. Why?
You've got this all wrong. If Lily was doing a special glamour, it wasn't for me. For fuck's sake, I want that kind of heat.
Who was she doing it for, then?
She had clients, Bigby. Maybe one of them was into it. Oh. A lot of fucked up people in Fable Town.
Like who?
Try looking in the mirror. Anyway, now what to do with me? Go on, then.
We're not done here.
I think we are.
I said we're not.
you're gonna hit me, go ahead. That's what you wanna do, right? That's what you came here for, right?
One more time. Who hired her?
Oh no, fuck! You! Take your sad fucking face where I can't see it! Bloody bastard fucking shit! You proud of yourself, mate? Proud of your little mess?
I didn't do anything.
Fuck's sake. Fuck up, Hans.
Hold on a minute. Hans, is it?
Hans just cleans up and provides a little muscle when we need it. He's not going to know anything about the girls and their clients or any of that. No one knows. Don't you get it? It's by design. Discretion is our guarantee, right? And the way we guarantee that is that no one knows anything they don't have to know, including me. I cover my eyes and take my cut. End of story.
Why not look it up?
What's that?
Isn't there a little book with all the stuff about the girls and all that written in it?
You're a fucking moron.
No.
There is no book. And as for you, Hans, we need to work on your communication skills and have a fairly good idea where to start. Hey, that's my personal property. Sure, go ahead. Do what comes naturally.
Tell me about the book.
You haven't got the slightest clue about anything. Hey, now!
No, I'm not gonna break anything.
Cut the crap, Georgie. I want the book Hans is talking about.
Hans is confused. Again. Don't even think about it.
Look, Georgie, why don't you just tell me where the book is?
Can we please not go round and round about this? There's no book. End of story. Do not touch that. You hear me? That's nothing to do with you.
There's still time for you to just cough it up.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but there's no handy magic book with everything you want to know jotted down inside. I sincerely wish there was. Maybe it would get you off me back.
I found it anyway.
Well, what's this? Looks like a floor safe.
I wouldn't know. It was here when we moved in. I don't have a key to it. Sheriff, will you come on? Fuck's sake, I've got to open up in a few hours.
Give it to me.
You're a big bad bastard. We get it. Everyone's guilty. We fucking get it.
I never said it.
Jesus. You're killing me! I'm begging you. I'll pay you.
Two women are dead.
Then quit being a bloody idiot. Come on, Nate. Leave it. There's nothing there for you.
You might want to stand back.
All right.
I didn't break anything in the end.
Bloody come on, then! Prick. Once again, don't get your hopes up. There's nothing in here that'll tell you anything. But it's a kick to the balls for me and my club, so you can be happy about that.
You can have it back after I've read through it.
Here. This is Lily's last entry. So tell me, Georgie. Who's this Mr. Smith?
Oh dear. I'm afraid it might be a fake name, Bigby. Secrecy is sort of how this all works. Even Hans knows that.
What's 207? Room number?
I don't fucking know. Millimeters, maybe?
Don't bullshit me, Georgie. This is your book. Your girls.
I'm not their fucking secretary. I give them a stage. I give them music. I provide an erotic venue to attract and retain clients.
But let's be clear on something. The girls make the arrangements with their clients, not me. The girls. They're the ones with the Mr. Smiths and Joneses and Mr. X types. Whatever happens outside the club, that's on them. I log the business, take my cut, and I'm out. Now, I've had quite enough of you and your bullying. Excuse me while I call your superiors to make a complaint.
Let's go have a look-see. Oh!
Hello. Business off.
Anyway, guys, that's all I've got time for. We've hit the mark. Okay. So, until next time. I'll see ya. Bye.